All right. Follow this closely. This is Frankenstein. This is Mary Shelley, the writer of Frankenstein. Mary Shelley was the daughter of William Godwin and Mary Wollstonecraft. This is Mary Shelley's husband, Percy Shelley, a famous romantic poet. Percy Shelley was friends with Lord Byron. Lord Byron's daughter was Ada Lovelace. This sort of one genius knowing another being related to a third makes it seem as though they exist in some other sort of world. Kind of like a reality superseding that what fiction describes. And it is such a reality that makes today's poet, Dag the Helvi, so interesting. Some relations are drawn from the poets we discussed in the past episodes, and some new characters come about. Dag the Helvi was born by the name of Nawab Mirza Khan on 25th May 1831 in Chandni Chowk, that place is now often referred to as Kucha Ustad Dag. We'll come back to why he's called Ustad Dag, but let's go back to Chandni Chowk. In the second episode, we discussed Ghalib, Mirza Ghalib, and how he was a prominent poet at the time. Now, when Dag was coming about, he was still younger than Ghalib, but he lived very close to him. Let's take a look at the map. As we can see, Dag lives very close to where Mirza Ghalib was staying in Ballimaran. Dag was the son to Nawab Shamsuddin Ahmad Khan, the ruler of Loharu, and his wife Wazir Khanam. While he was still young, Dag's father, the Nawab, was arrested under the charges of assassinating William Fraser. Now, William Fraser, again, has a certain relationship to Ghalib, and you can go into that once again. But so now things start getting very interesting. So Dag's father is arrested and is going to be executed. Dag's mother, Wazir Khanam, is very sought after during this period. And so she soon marries Mirza Muhammad Fakhru. Now, who's Mirza Muhammad Fakhru? The son of Bahadur Shah Zafar, which the first episode was on. So now Dag, by virtue of being Wazir Khanam's son, who is now somehow the wife of one of the Mughal princes, moves into Lal Qila and finds these resources around him. Zawq and Ghalib at this time were recognized poets, and suddenly at the age of 10, Dag the Helvi's name is also considered as one of the poets of the time. From the get-go itself, Dag seemed to be a promising poet. Dag belonged to Dabistan-e-Dilli. We discussed with Mir as well, who emphasized using easy, simple language in poetry, but Dag as well used very simple language in his ghazal. Further, it could be put to music very well. It was very poetic and fluent in that sense, which made it even more accessible. After Mirza Fakhru's death, Dag moved to Rampur, and he stayed here quite comfortably for 24 years. Here in Rampur, Dag would make a very important acquaintance with another poet and rival, Amir. Amir belonged to the Lucknow school of poetry, and at Rampur, Amir and Dag were significant faces to these two schools. Finally, after Delhi to Rampur, Dag moves to Hyderabad. But what Dag later became more known for was not just his poetry in itself or that he was some sort of a prodigy, but that he was a very good teacher. Dag did not have a couple dozen students or a couple hundred, but thousands of students spread across Hindustan. One of his students was Allama Iqbal, who I also mentioned in Faiz Ahmad Faiz's video. While Allama Iqbal did not meet Dag the Helvi, he was proud of calling him his teacher. Finally, Dag died at the age of 74 in Hyderabad and was buried in Dargah Yusufain, a perfect resting ground for a poet who lived amidst the greatest. Dag was known for his romantic poetry, and because of which I've chosen today's ghazal, Narawa Kahiye. This ghazal recently featured in A Suitable Boy, a drama series on Netflix, and was liked by many. It might be interesting now to listen to it and keep in mind where Dag is coming from, the story behind him, and the sort of fairy tale that manifests itself in the setting he grew up in and the relationships around him. And so we have today's ghazal, Narawa Kahiye.
Narwa kahiye na saza kahiye narwa kahiye ना सजा कहिए 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 मुझे बुरा कहिए ना रवा कहिए इंतहा इश्क की खुदा जाने इंतहा इश्क की खुदा जाने दम आखिर को कहिए दमे आखिर को इब्तिदा कहिए 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 मुझे बुरा कहिए ना सजा कहिए सब्र फुरकत में आ ही जाता है सब्र फुरकत में आ ही जाता है पर उसे देर आशना कहिए पर उसे देर आशना कहिए 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 मुझे बुरा कहिए ना रवा कहिए होश जाते रहे रकीबों के होश जाते रहे रकीबों के दाग को और बावफा कहिए दाग को और कहिए 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 मुझे बुरा कहिए ना रवा कहिए ना सजा कहिए।